The protest that played out last Wednesday at the Makindye Magistrates Court has drawn widespread condemnation across the country. Supporters of the Inspector General of Police stormed court premises to protest against his prosecution. A group of lawyers dragged General Kale Kaihura and seven other officers to court to answer torture charges after video footage of police officers beating up supporters of former FDC presidential candidate Dr. Kizza Besigye was broadcast last month. The private lawyers invoked a section of the Prevention and Prohibition of Torture Act, which makes spurious criminally liable for actions of their subordinates. Now religious leaders under their umbrella group, Inter-Religious Council of Uganda, have also weighed in on the Makindye court protest. They are warning that such actions could lead the country down the path of anarchy. The leaders are also calling for the respect of the judicial institutions and the rule of law by all persons regardless of their status.
This was not very good. We need to leave the judges and the magistrates and other people administering law to do their work independently. So when citizens take the law into their hands, then they are destroying the institution that should be helping this country.
If government is promoting just the judiciary and you come and try to fight against it, then you are in the wrong. So I think people should be educated so that they understand fully the importance and need and use of the judiciary.
Members of the Mount Faith Coalition and the Elders Forum of Uganda are currently holding a three-day retreat in Mukono District to lay strategies of promoting dialogue among Ugandan leaders. The retreat was opened by the Minister for General Duties, Mary Karoro Kurot. It is a follow-up of an earlier one held in March after the general elections.
This building is a nationwide activity that should transcend the confines of the NRM stroke opposition misunderstandings.
The members are also pushing for a constitutional amendment that would make it mandatory for the government to implement resolutions passed by the Inter-Religious Council of Uganda.
IRCU and the respective members are doing a very good job, but we have no authority because we are not recognized in the national constitution.
This country knows that we exist, but we are not recognized by the constitution. So we are appealing to government to recognize the Inter-Religious Council of Uganda.
This will be the second attempt that the religious leaders are making to set up a national dialogue for Ugandans to discuss issues of governance. The first attempt they made after the 2011 elections failed to take off. Habad Ziwa, NTV. Yeah, yeah.